Even as a freshman, Lexis Gower knows how intense soccer can be when balls start flying.
So when I turned around, she hit me right in the head.
It happened during club soccer last fall. The result? A concussion.
I had really bad headaches, and I lost memory.
And she's not alone.
We had 3 concussions on the girls' side.
Lady Vikes coach Louis DeLeonardo says the incident sent school officials looking for a solution.
We thought that as a school, we want to make the choice to make our players, give them a safe environment.
They found these concussion bands. They're lightweight with padding all around designed to lessen impact, especially from heading.
A lot of them will take the impact up here instead of on the front of their head where they're supposed to. And so I don't think that's an issue. Now they have a target kind of idea. This is where I'm supposed to head the ball.
Boys had the option of wearing the bands last fall, but this spring it's mandatory equipment for the girls. The adjustment's been tougher for some.
They fall off consistently, and when you tie it tight, you get a headache as you wear it. I feel like sometimes it makes it go off in an opposite direction that I planned on it going because of the extra cushion.
For Lexis, it's a minor inconvenience.
I mean, they're just hot.
After a 4.5-month recovery, she's finally back on the pitch and hoping the bands help keep her there.
I feel a little safer with it.
While studies aren't yet showing just how much safer they'll be, Coach DeLeonardo says it's worth a try to keep concussions from sidelining anyone else.
You're not talking about, you know, something that's going to affect you a short time. You can't go get this fixed. I mean, it's going to affect you the rest of your life. So we have to do something to try to help them out.
The new menu at the Topeka Zoo's Grazers Cafe invites you to eat like the animals, which is a good thing.
And when we took a look at ourselves and saw what we were feeding people that came here, we knew that we had to do something different.
The result? Teaming with Shawnee County's sodium reduction campaign for a menu makeover.
One of the first things that we did was we got rid of our fryer and we replaced it with a convection oven, which instantly made a difference.
The menu does still have things like fries and chicken strips, but they're baked instead of fried. The hamburger is leaner. Grilled chicken, tuna, a veggie wrap, and fruit and veggie sides are now on the menu. And at prices intentionally competitive with the candy.
What we've really done is adjust that model so that cost is not the only driving factor, but what's in the food that we purchase.
Health experts say the changes, coupled with the awareness campaign, are a good sign.
I don't think people are aware of what they're eating and how we're gravitating more towards quick convenience foods.
Stormont Vale dietitian Mary Alice Shear says most Americans consume about 3,400 milligrams of sodium a day. It's recommended we only get this much, 2,300 milligrams, and it's not that hard to reach it. Too much sodium increases blood pressure and fluid in your body, making it harder for the heart to work. Shear says read labels to spot the salt and take a fresh approach to your meals.
Cook more from homemade, using lower sodium ingredients, more whole foods.
Wiley says the zoo has reduced the sodium in its menu a whopping 2/3, and people seem to be eating it up.
People are happy to pick from what we have. They're getting healthier food. And in many cases, they're pleasantly surprised at what they can find.
St. Mary's Fire Chief Ray Bartholy is always on the go.
It's nonstop. We have 11 fire trucks, do all the maintenance. We have probably about 500 fire hoses. They have to be tested annually.
But for the past 3 years, he's battled a little problem that grew into something major.
Didn't go to the doctor as soon as I should have, and it got to where it was getting worse daily.
Ray, who's had problems related to diabetes since he was diagnosed in his 30s, developed a blister on his foot that became infected. Eventually, he had his toes and part of his right foot amputated. The blister came back and again wouldn't heal.
I was fearful that I would probably lose more leg, and I think I was very close to that.
But then Ray's family doctor referred him to a wound specialist, which brought him to the hyperbaric oxygen chambers at the Stormont Vale Wound Care Center.
It's a technique where we can improve wound healing by increasing the amount of oxygen that the patient breathes.
Dr. Robert Holmes says cells need oxygen to repair themselves. Increasing oxygen in the bloodstream can stimulate healing, especially in diabetics like Ray.
Part of the problem with many wounds is that the circulation is so poor that we don't get enough oxygen to the skin. The skin begins to die, or the new skin that's trying to grow in an effort to heal the wound can't survive.
Treatments typically last 2 hours. They're done daily for a total of 20 to 40 treatments, depending on the severity of the wound. Ray's treatments were done in conjunction with advanced wound therapy, where a lab-created layer of skin grown from human cells is placed over the affected area.
And that skin tissue provides the nutrients and the chemicals and all the proteins that are necessary for wound healing to begin.
Ray went from the grimmest of prospects.
Unfortunately, Ray's really only other option would have been amputation.
To opening the door on reaching his future goals.
I have another 5 years, 5.5 years to go to retirement. I'd like to be able to do that.
Melissa Brunner, 13 News.